because a simple greedy algorithm produces a true approximation for our load balancing problem, but nothing better than a true approximation. We should ask ourselves whether some other efficient algorithm is able to produce something that is better than a true approximation. And the answer is yes, there is such a better algorithm. And one example for a better algorithm is the so-called LPT rule. LPT stands for longest processing time first. And it's the same greedy algorithm that we considered before, with a slight modification that rather than considering the jobs in arbitrary order, we first sort them in descending order of their processing times. So we consider the heaviest, the biggest, the longest processing jobs first, and then work our way down to the shorter, easier jobs. When we do this, we avoid this trap that our previous greedy algorithm falls into, that is shown in this construction that we had, where the last job we consider was somehow much bigger than the jobs we considered before. We can reuse many of our previous arguments to show that this LPT algorithm gives a 1.5 approximation. The only thing we really need is a refinement of the lower bound for the optimum make span. Remember that we said that the optimum make span has to be at least as large as the processing time of any of the jobs. But we can say a bit more. Suppose the jobs are sorted in descending order of their processing times, meaning the first job is the one with the largest processing time, the second job is the one with the second largest processing time, and so on. Now, consider the M plus one largest job, assuming such a job exists. So if we have more than M jobs, then the optimal make span has to be at least as large as two times the size of the M plus one largest job. And the reason for this is the following. Consider the first M plus one jobs. Now, because they're ordered in descending order of their processing times, each of those jobs has a processing time that is at least as large as the processing time of the M plus oneth job. And that means we have M plus one many jobs, and each of them has a processing time of at least Tm plus one. But we only have M machines, so at least two of those jobs have to be placed on the same machine by the pigeonhole principle. And that machine gets two of those jobs, and therefore the load of that machine will be at least two times the processing time of the M plus one job. So if we have fewer than M jobs in total, then our algorithm is optimal anyway, because each job can just be placed on an individual machine, not having to share that machine with any other job. So that's an optimal allocation that will produce the smallest possible make span. Otherwise, we can now use the refined lower bound on the optimal make span and plug this into the calculation that we had before anyway. Consider the machine with the largest load in the end. Let that be machine I, and the load of that machine is Li. If the machine only contains a single job in the end, then we have an optimal solution, because clearly the optimum make span needs to be at least as large as the processing time of that single job. Otherwise, that machine contains at least two jobs. And it's important to note that the second job that is assigned to that machine cannot be one of the first M jobs in the sequence, because the first M job in the sequence are assigned to individual machines. We only start to place a second job on a machine once each machine contains at least one job. So we can simply split the load of machine I again into the part that we have before the last job J was assigned to that machine and the processing time of job J itself. And the first part of this is bounded in the same way as before by the optimal make span. And the latter part of this, which is the processing time of this job J, that must be bounded by the size of the M plus 1 largest job. Because again, the jobs are considered in decreasing order of their size. This cannot be any of the first M jobs, so it must be later in that sequence. And therefore, the size of the job can be at most as big as the M plus 1 largest job. And we know that the size of the M plus 1 largest job is a lower bound for the optimal make span divided by 2. And so we just plug all of this in and we get that the load of machine I at the very end of the allocation is at most 3/2 times the optimal make span.